Mr. Ron Hard, it's wonderful to meet you.
Likewise.
Thanks for chatting to the big review-ski on JOE today. It's much appreciated. Yeah. So, I was wondering, let's get the definitive pronunciation of Solo's first name out of the way so far, because it causes a wee bit of debate in the film.
Well,
so.
It does. It's Han. He explains it's Han. Lando keeps calling him Han. It irks Han a little bit, but I don't know if Lando's forgetting or if he's just giving it to him a little bit.
I suspect it's a wee bit of a laugh. It's better. A lot of people still call him Hans Solo, so either one of those is better. Do you remember whenever you came in to work on Solo and sitting down that first day to take a look at the earlier footage?
Right.
Do you remember sitting down and kind of looking and knowing, right, I know exactly what I want to do here? Or having a feeling of, do you know what, I really like a certain part? And, you know, so what was that first day?
Well, it was a combination. And that was when I came in, it was regrettable there'd been this difference. Phil and Chris were very talented directors, great guys, very gracious guys. We had a good meeting, talked a little bit about it. I took it from there. And there was a real spirit of experimentation in exploring things that we could try a different way. Sometimes we'd go with the way that I staged it. Sometimes we'd go back to something that Phil and Chris had done. But it was interesting because there were. I was very grateful for a lot of ideas that I was inheriting. But I also had this creative latitude to bring my objectivity, my sensibility to the process, and kind of continue. Developing things. So even as we were shooting all the way through post-production, we kept inventing slightly different perspectives on scenes, whoever had initially directed them. But the story was hatched before there was any director. Before Disney acquired Lucasfilm, this was an idea that Larry Kasdan, Kathy Kennedy, and George Lucas had talked about being a sort of an obvious one that they thought fans would enjoy.
Some of the more recent Star Wars films, there have been some really interesting cameos, whether it's Daniel Craig with his head stuck in a stormtrooper helmet, or I think Tom Hardy was rumored to be in there as well. Yeah. Have you any nice, interesting cameos in your film?
We really don't. Tom Hanks was interested in being a stormtrooper. But
well, that would have been amazing.
It would have been great. He was shooting, and he just couldn't get there. But now that Lucasfilm knows that Hanks is interested, I'm sure they'll work it out someday.
Well, did you enjoy this? Do you want to come back and do more?
Well, right. I literally finished 10 days ago. So
I need an answer, Ron.
I had far more fun than I expected I would, and I felt comfortable. I'm just beginning to get the feedback from the fans. That's very encouraging. And by the way, there's no definitive program that suggests there's going to be, a Han Solo sequel. I think they're going to hear from the fans. That's the way Lucasfilm feels, and I think that's the way I feel too. But I did have a lot of fun with it.
As an Irishman, we're 25 years on now from Far and Away,
wow.
And I'm wondering, the accents in that film always get a little bit of conversation around Tom Cruise and Nicole Kidman, but. What are your kind of any fond memories of your time in Ireland, and who was better at the Irish accent, Tom or Nicole?
Yeah, entirely fond memories. In fact, of all of my kids, Bryce and Paige and Reed and Jocelyn, it's their favorite location that we ever went on, especially Dingle. I love Dublin as well. The whole thing was great, and it was I have a lot of affection for that movie. We all tried our best. I think Nicole's probably a little more gifted with accents, but Tom is ever the hard worker, and he gave it everything he had, and we worked hard at it.
Well, there's been a lot of Star Wars filmed in Ireland, so if you ever bring in more Solo films back, you're more than welcome.
Oh, that'd be great.
Push it!